Hey guys, welcome back here. If you may have noticed on the forums on Facebook, I am doing a league record rush, push, whatever you want to call it. So the league record actually just reset, like, 5 hours ago or so. The old league record was like 34,000, so I was trying to beat that one. And so now I have the new league record, but it doesn't update until it gets a day in 6 hours. So it can constantly change from here to now. So you still have to upgrade your medals and make sure you have a good record so it doesn't get broken easily. And as people do break the record, this will, the medals will go up and this will go up as well. So I can't place mine there until one day in 6 hours when my tournament ends and then it updates the league record. So currently I have it. If someone were to come along and put like 20,000 on there, today, then I, would have to get up to 21,000 to break his record. So it is always good to just build more medals and get more, a better record to set the standard high. So I'm going to show you some medal farming and just some pretty much grinding it out, because there's really no farming currently. We are going to attack some high-level players as well. We're also going to just mess around. So there's not going to be much audio on this videos. And this will be a very, very long stream. I may chop it up into little different parts and bits. So there's going to be some, epic fails in there. We are going to attack, tough opponents. We aren't using really gold boosting things. We are going pretty much strictly for medals. We are also trying to fill up our treasure chamber a little bit, but that's just a secondary feature of all these battles we're doing. So you can see we have 7,800,000 in our gold chamber. We do want to fill that up so I can do a big video on the new, secret way to get armor and gear. And that is by filling up your treasure chamber to completely max. And then every time you defeat someone in a base, in a raid, you will actually get to choose gear almost always from the treasure chamber. So there'll be gear, maybe food sometimes, maybe some gems and pearls, but there won't be any gold in those treasure chests when you open them up. So go ahead and take a look. Favorite people we have been attacking. We have been trying to attack Chasen. We can defeat him with no scrolls. I actually don't have the mortars on, so we might not be able to beat him with this setup. But yeah, typically we can beat him without any scrolls. So, bear a mistake. And then he does like to change up his base, fairly often. So things do change. And this base is a little bit different design than what he was using, a few hours ago. My spells have actually got upgraded. If you did notice, I did spend a lot of gems. I had about 10,000 gems the other day. And now I'm down to a little over 5,000, I believe. And so I've been buying a lot of things. I've bought a 7-day gold shield, a 1-day gold shield. I have bought a new armor piece. And then I also have sped up some of my skills or spells. So my heal spell is level 10. My sonic blast is level 5. And my Blade Storm is level 6. So our spells are creeping up to max level. Yeah, we're definitely not going to be able to beat him this time. Mortars actually make a huge difference against the Arblasters. It's really weird because you wouldn't think that like a mortar would do that much difference. But the poison damage that the mortar does is pretty substantial. And it also lingers on the ground, so it also affects other units that kind of walk by it. So the mortars actually do a pretty good amount of damage, and the Arblasters are actually weak to poison too. So we'll go in there and show you a battle with the Arblasters actually on. You can see that was a mistake. Against him, I don't go in there with paladins. That was for someone else. But I always like to try and attack him, because he does give a lot of loot. And a good amount of medals. So you'll see, but he did change his base up, but you'll see more of the actual strategy that works against Chasen. Anyone that uses a lot of Arb Blasters, you'll see that the mortar is kind of like the big counter to those. Again, no promise that we will win this battle. You know, there are a lot of variables, and he has changed his base. So this is not the same base that I have been attacking for the last few hours yesterday. Pretty much the main focus is you want to kill all of the Skull Towers and then all the troops. And if you can do those things, your Pyromancers will be able to take care of most of the Firebolt Towers. Your spells will do some damage to them as well. Ugh. So yes, he did change that section up right there. You just have to learn the rhythm and the pattern to actually get through his base again. And then once you kind of get it down, then it should be okay. He might have changed it to where we can't beat it, actually, which would be a good change on his part. Because different tweaks to your base can actually greatly affect the difficulty of the base. You know, a small minor placement of, tower movement or road change can have a huge, huge impact on your base layout and base defense. So the bright side, every time we lose to him, we actually increase the metal counts that we're going to win. So that's the only bright side about losing. So we finally are able to get the attack pattern down slightly.
gentlemen. Come on. Are you?
Upstairs, I'm gonna go get the medicines. He's upstairs. Yeah. This is medicines. They said to have all the medicines for you so you could see. And there's more upstairs. Yeah, I think he has some supplies. Yeah.